I'm Fraser Cain, the publisher of Universe Today. Look up, there's space. Astronomically speaking, it's right there outside a thin layer of atmosphere. But how far away is it? How high is space? Space is defined by the point at which the Earth's atmosphere ends and the vacuum takes over. As you can probably imagine, with such a subjective definition, people disagree on exactly where space begins. One definition of space came from the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, the predecessor to NASA, who decided on the point where atmospheric pressure was less than 1 pound per square foot. This was the altitude that airplane control surfaces could no longer be used and corresponded to roughly 50 miles or 81 kilometers. Any NASA test pilot or astronaut who crosses this altitude is awarded their astronaut wings. Shortly after that definition, the aerospace engineer Theodor von Karman calculated that above an altitude of 100 kilometers, the atmosphere would be so thin that an aircraft would need to be traveling at orbital velocity to derive any lift. This altitude was later adopted as the Karman line by the World Air Sports Federation. When Felix Baumgartner broke the record for the highest freefall in 2012, he jumped from an altitude of 39 kilometers, less than halfway to space, according to NASA's definition. But the atmosphere of the Earth extends far out into space. Even though it orbits at an altitude of more than 400 kilometers, the International Space Station needs to be constantly boosted because of friction with the atmosphere. Satellites that orbit at a higher altitude can orbit for decades or even hundreds of years without slowing down from atmospheric drag. But the Earth's outer atmosphere, also known as the exosphere, extends out to an altitude of 10,000 kilometers above the planet. Although the atmosphere is tenuous, there are more gas particles in this region than interplanetary space. Whatever the exact definition of space you use, if you can get above 100 kilometers, I think you deserve your astronaut wings. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel over here. And maybe you've still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see the question you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.